Hi everyone, this is Marine for Learn Fun, and today's project was inspired by this card I made for Valentine's release week, and I thought it would be fun to make a winter version of it. But before moving on to the coloring, here's a quick look of the stamp and die sets I used. Special Delivery, Getty or Not for the tree and accessories, Simply Celebrate Winter for the trees and houses, Happy Village for the car, Winter Village for the street lamp, small tree, chimney smoke and snowbank, Holiday Party Animal for the tiny beanie, Holiday Helpers for my sentiment, Tiny Christmas for the boy, girl and puppy, The Waving Pool Tap Starter die set, The Largest Die from Large Stitch Rectangle Stackables, The Smallest Die from Stitch Simple Wavy Borders, The Strip Die from Picket Fence Border, and finally the Snowy Backdrop. So I stamped all my cute images using jet black ink and colored them using my alcohol markers, spectrum markers and graphite brush markers. And to match the winter theme I had in mind, I used cold tones, mostly grays and blues, to color everything. Thank you. When the coloring was done, I cut the images using the coordinating dies and moved on to the background. I first cut a snowy backdrop out of Bristol cardstock. And then I put my panel a second time in my die-cut machine along with the stitch rectangle die to add stitch details to my snowy panel. Next, I picked my distress inks, cracked pistachio, peacock feathers, and blueprint sketch. I took my first card as a reference to see where I needed to start the sky, and then I finally applied the inks. I first applied cracked pistachio towards almost half of the panel. Next, I applied peacock feathers on the rest of the panel towards the cracked pistachio section and blended the colors. And finally, to bring more contrast to that sky, I added blueprint sketch at the very top. I really love this color combo, it's just perfect for winter and Christmas cards. Once I was happy with the blending, I added some texture, but not too much, because the panel was already pretty busy with the stars and snow. So I just mixed the same inks I used before with water and created small droplets on the paper using a thin brush. To ground the scene, I cut a wavy border out of Bristol cardstock, a strip out of narwhal cardstock, and a part of a rectangle out of fog cardstock. I set the grey pieces aside and applied a tiny bit of cracked pistachio distress ink on the wavy top edge of the border to not have just a plain white element. And before moving on to the interactive part of my card, I applied a whole lot of liquid glue at the back of my snowy panel and then stuck it to some pixie dust paper. I waited until the glue was dry, trimmed off the excess of paper, and then to the interactive part using the Waving Pull Tab starter die set. I placed the notch die at the top of my panel, right up against the edge, and secured it with washi tape. Next, I placed the stencil with the curvy edge against the notch die, and placed the double slot die on the bottom part of the stencil. I secured that double slot die as well and sent the panel to my die-cut machine. And this is what we get, a notch at the top and two slots below it. Off-screen, I die-cut a pull tab and two sleeves. I turned the panel over and took the pull tab. On one side, there is an embossed line. I turned the pull tab over to have that line at the back and placed a brad from the back through the small hole. Next, I placed each wing on that brad with the right side on top. And I opened the brad to keep those wings in place. Next, I folded the wings a little bit and put them through the slots at the back of my panel. And next, I needed to keep the pull tab straight, so I folded the two sleeves and applied a strong double-sided tape on the middle part of each element. And I placed the first one right between the embossed line and those teeny tiny tabs. I placed the second sleeve below the brad. I like to use two sleeves instead of just one, because sometimes with only one sleeve, the pull tab can go off a little bit. So attaching two sleeves really helps to keep it straight. Next, I closed both sleeves, tested the tab to see if it was working well, and it was, so I stuck the remaining piece of sky on the front at the top of the pull tab. And finally, I stuck the owl right between the wings using a piece of foam tape. Before assembling my images on my panel, I stamped my sentiment on the wavy border. I started by stamping Merry Christmas using clear embossing ink. I applied silver embossing powder on the ink and used my heat tool to melt the powder. I put the border back in my Misty tool and this time I stamped "May you get everything you wish for" in black. Next, I was finally ready to put everything together and I started by applying foam tape at the back of my panel, making sure not to touch the mechanism, to attach my panel on a Peacock card base. And then to my favorite part, which is assembling all the images to create a cute little scene. I started by layering the three borders to ground my scene, and then I used foam squares and a tiny bit of liquid glue to stick the images. Once everything was attached, the last step was to add an arrow at the top of the pull tab. And that's it, this is the final result, and this lovely owl is ready to deliver happy mails during the holidays. And just for comparison, here are both cards next to each other so you can tell which one is your favorite. Thank you so much for watching, have a very Merry Christmas, stay safe, and I will see you very soon. Bye!